Hi everybody, I am that nursing prof and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking all about the medication levothyroxine. And this is a big med that you will probably give in your practice. It's very commonly prescribed, so that's why I wanted to make this video so you would feel a little bit more comfortable when you give this med to your patients. So let's get into it. So the brand name of this medication is called Synthroid. Maybe you've heard of that before. And this is used as a hormone replacement. So people who have hypothyroidism, they don't produce enough of the thyroid hormone, thyroxine, or they don't produce any at all. So this medication is meant to replace that hormone. So it's used for people with hypothyroidism or with thyroid cancer. And without your thyroid, it can be an issue, right? Without that thyroid hormone. So the patient might experience things like poor growth in children, lack of energy, weight gain, hair loss, joint and muscle pain, depression, just to name a few. Constipation is another big one. I do have a full video on hypothyroidism that I will link below, but these are just some big side effects that the patient might experience if they have it. So the point of this medication is to manage those symptoms so that the patient doesn't have to live with these symptoms. And important to note, it can take up to 2 months for the patient to start seeing a change. Some people, they start taking this medication and they see a change within the first couple of weeks, which is great, right? But some people, it takes a little bit longer, so they might get a little discouraged, like, why hasn't anything happened yet? So it's important for you as the nurse to let them know that it might take up to 2 months before they start seeing a difference. When it comes to side effects of this medication, a lot of them are just symptoms of overactive thyroid, meaning it's working a little too well, this medication. So those symptoms include things like increased sweating, headaches, heart palpitations, nervousness, tremors, mood swings or like irritability, and things like hot flashes or a sensitivity to heat. Some important patient education that you're going to need to teach them is you have to be careful with using this med and other sorts of medications. So some common meds this might interact with include amiodarone, birth control pills, and phenytoin. Now, when it comes to birth control pills or estrogen hormone replacement, that's also a very common medication. So people who are of reproductive age that are actively not trying to get pregnant right now, they might be on this. And then also our menopausal patients who are going through those symptoms, it's the same medication, that hormone replacement therapy. So a lot of people will be on this medication and it might interact with this. So it's important that you know that about your patient and you ask them and take a detailed med rec. You want to avoid certain things in the diet. So tell them to avoid things like kelp, soybeans, walnuts, and grapefruit, as it could interact with the medication. Something a little bit different about this med is switching brands may alter your thyroid level. That's not something we normally think about. If you buy, you know, Tylenol or you buy acetaminophen, the store brand, it doesn't really matter, right? You're not going to see a difference. They're going to act the same. But with Synthroid, it might be different. So if you're switching different brands, if you're switching from brand to generic, that might alter your levels and you might see some changes. So that's something to keep an eye on and to let them know about. Other medications that are common, like Tums or iron supplements, they can take those, that's fine, but you need to educate them that they need to be done in a 4-hour window. So either 4 hours after or 4 hours before. We recommend you take on an empty stomach 30 minutes to an hour prior to breakfast. That's what most people do. They wake up in the morning and the first thing they do is they take that pill. And then the other thing you need to educate your clients on is about blood tests. So the way this medication works is it alters your thyroid levels. So the dose for each individual patient is going to depend on how their body reacts to it. So when your patient first starts on this medication, they're going to get regular blood tests, and we're going to start on the lowest dose, right? And then increase as appropriate until we get to the appropriate level for them. And then once it's been established, like, okay, this is what you need, you're doing well on this, then the blood test will just be once a year. But initially, they're going to be more frequent to monitor those levels. And then some exceptions to this, if your patient is pregnant or sometimes the elderly, they might need to get their levels drawn a little bit more frequently than once a year. But those are just some exceptions. Everybody needs to get those blood tests at first to make sure that they're on the appropriate amount of this medication. Because remember, all those side effects come from having high doses of the medication, too high. So we want to make sure that everything is as it's supposed to be. So that's it. This is my video. I hope you found this helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. And if not, I'll see you on the next one.